share this lecture with your friends and batchmates, and for more such lectures, subscribe to The Last Venture Comrade. Let us see another example, which is of a full adder circuit. So we shall have three inputs, that is A, B and C input, and two outputs, that are C out and S for sum. So we shall construct a truth table that will be A, B, C, and for the two outputs, that is S and C out. So for these three inputs A, B, C, we shall have possible combinations of 8, that is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1, 1. So for sum, we know that it is 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. And for C out, that will be 3, 5, 6, 7. So 0001, 0, 1, 1, 1. Now for drawing the binary decision diagram or BDD, the same procedure will be applied again. So for this sum, we are drawing first. Now let me quickly just mention out the nodes and draw the BDD diagram of the step 1 where no reduction is there. Now this is the step 1 BDD diagram we have obtained. So from the truth table 0001, okay, that is for C out, we have to follow this one first. So it is for S value 0110001. So just quickly filling out the terminal nodes with these value 0110001. Now the second step, let me draw just side by side so we can compare it. This is step 2 where we are removing the terminal nodes and reducing them to 0 and 1, just the two nodes. Okay, so I'll just quickly draw it. So here the three levels are drawn, and from CI how we will move towards 0 and 1, that I'll show you. So this is 0 for 0, 0, we are getting 0, 1 pay, it is getting 1, 0 pay 1, 1 pay 0, then this is 0 pay 1, 1 pay 0, 0 pay 0, 1 pay 1. So this is the leaf removal step. Sometimes the examiners require the students to mention the steps and detail them, like what type of removal it is, vertex removal or leaf removal or redundant nodes removal. Now see whether any reduction is possible in this. Let me try these four CI nodes. I think we can reduce them to two, because this CI node and this CI node. For 0, both are coming to 0. For 1, both are going to 1. And for these two CI nodes, you can see that when for condition 1, they are going to 0. And for condition 0, they are going to 1. So yes, we can replace these two with one single CI node. And these two CI nodes with one single CI node. So we are reducing the total number of nodes in this diagram by 2. So I shall just quickly again draw the step 3 where we are removing the nodes. Okay, so I have drawn this diagram for step 3, and see, you can see that in place of these 4 CI nodes, we are left with just the 2 CI nodes. So what we will do now for this first and fourth, how should we solve it? 0, 0, we are arriving at this. So here we will draw for condition 0, and this CI is for 0, it is 0, and for 1, this is 1. Okay, and see, this node is solved. Now I shall target this one. So for 0, this CI node is also 0, and for 1, it is also 1. So we have to arrive from B to this CI node, not this one. Okay, I hope you got it. This is 1 and again 1. So we are following the path of condition 1, and I'm so sorry, it should be 1, and then again for 0, 0, for 1, 1. Okay, now these two nodes are solved. Now solving these two middle nodes, for this second node, this is 0, then 1. We have to go to this node, 0 and then 1. So what this CI node does, for 0 it goes to 1, for 0 it goes to 1, and for 1 it goes to 0. Okay, and this third one, 1, 0, 1, and this is 0. Don't consider this branch, it was by mistake. And 1, 0, for 0 it is going to 1, for 0 it is going to 1, for 1 it is going to 0. Okay, so now we have arrived at a diagram which I can refer as ROBDD for this particular question, that is full adder circuit sum. Okay, now the second part, that is C out. So what will be the C out for this full adder circuit? So I suggest you to try this out as an exercise, and I am going to draw the ROBDD diagram to which you can refer just to check your result. I hope you could have solved this ROBDD for C out of the full adder. And if you want to cross check, I am just giving out here the ROBDD of full adder for the output C, that is C out, carry output. So this is the ROBDD obtained. You can cross check it. So in total, 3 examples have been discussed on BDD or ROBDD topic. So I hope that is enough for you in this topic. In case you have any of the queries or questions about ROBDD, just put them down in the comment section, or you can mail me at lastventurecomrade@gmail.com. So from my side, this binary decision diagram topic and extendable to ROBDD topic also, this is all complete with the discussion of these few examples. Now in case you want me to make a video on any of the topic, just mention that particular topic in the comment, or you can always email me. Thank you so much for giving your time. Keep learning. Stay tuned. Please show your appreciation by clicking the like button. Share this lecture with your friends and batchmates. And for more such lectures, subscribe to The Last Venture Comrade.